Está buenísimo.
The definition of a song could be any number of things. It doesn't have to be this kind of like, you know, thing that has a beginning, middle, and end necessarily. It can be.
When did I ever say that? When did I say that?
It can be like. Like, I started writing songs based on loops. Once I got my looper, it opened up a whole new situation for me because what I started doing is. Not writing songs from a guitar standpoint, but writing them from a looping standpoint. So I would just start to.
So like phrases.
Well, what I was doing is I was defining the. I was almost like working from the outside in. So it's almost like I was doing all the production first, and then backing my way back into the song. Because I was able to define what the song sounded like in its most lavish form before I wrote it. You know what I'm saying? So like, that's the great thing about the looping is I would have all these kind of soundscapey things going on, and that would then inspire different kinds of lyrics based on those elements, as opposed to the opposite of starting with a guitar and just it being really simple and raw. And usually what people do is they write the song and then they add the production later. But this is a whole different method where you just do the production first.
It's already long.
Huh?
I told you, that's just studio production.
It's already long. Yeah. Yeah, or you do them simultaneously or something.
I do everything at the same time.
So the point
I
is...
I fix up the chords afterwards, but I always have
more. The difference from that... compared to the free write approach is that the free write doesn't start with music, it starts with words. So it just depends on where your head is at.
That's not necessarily true.
What do you start with, Ian?
No, because you could write the melody and the chorus and then do free write. The free write isn't like to start a song, the free write is just to get the lyrics.
Yeah. I guess I look at it more as a free sing. Like, in other words, the words that end up being formulated are a result of the music. So like I start making a sound, and that sound turns into a word.
The thing about that is like, it doesn't always, I mean, if you like always get a song out of that, it's good, but like, you also like, you're editing yourself while you're singing. Not like it has to like rhyme or whatever.
Not necessarily.
Or you're trying to fit it into the song, but you like have to get the idea out, you know? Like, I don't know.
It can work both ways.
It can.
Because sometimes what happens is...
It's just easier though to write. Like, I'm not saying like a free write, but just like if you have like an idea like in your head, I'm like
go ahead. This is gonna be our new. It's gonna be our rockumentary. We're gonna make a rockumentary.
Are you working tonight? I don't know. Sometimes, like, before putting in a song, you have to give yourself space to, like, actually, like, have an idea, you know?
Yeah, I mean, that's a valid approach. I'm just saying that, for some people, the words come out directly out of the melody for me. Like, the words...
Oh, yeah, definitely. That's how I get all my song ideas when you're building from
Like Bono from U2, they used to make fun of him, and he had his own language. They called it Bonoese, because he would go in the studio and just sing gibberish, like no language, just gibberish, and then the gibberish would eventually start turning into words. So in other words, the words, it's more like you define the sounds you want first. It's like Zach's song, really. I'm not sure how he writes, but it almost sounds like the writing was a result of, like, he wanted a certain set of sounds. It's almost like he had that first, and then he said, oh, well, maybe these are the words that sound more like what I'm trying to say. So you have to give yourself, you have to allow yourself to sound like an insane person. and just speak gibberish, the same gibberish, in order to, and then the words that come out of that then create their own themes. And like sometimes people write
also, like,
a theme.
My method of song writing, it's usually like I have like a melody that goes along with like words that just like came to my brain randomly, and I put it in voice memos. So I look through my voice memo and I'm like, hey, I want to build on this. And then I do a free write to get the rest of whatever I have, whether it's a chorus or a verse. And then I write all the rest together and I pull phrases from my free write. If I'm like at a loss for a lyric,
yeah,
I like circle the things I like in my free write that could be song lyrics, and I just
right.
pull them out and I put them where it's appropriate.
Yep.
So like you always, if you don't have that initial idea where it just kind of like comes to your head, then you can't really write a song.
The other thing I like to do to solve that problem is just learn to look at everything around you and turn it into something more mysterious. You could say three cups and a sweet touch. Here's your sweet touch. So you got three cups and a sweet touch. What does that mean? So that could turn into anything. That could turn into
alcohol cup.
Good. Or it could turn into you had three cups of coffee with someone you like, and then they touched you on your hand and it was a sweet touch. And then you go through it. So you gotta have like imagination,
Well, that's kind of like free writing, but without writing it down.
Yeah, true.
That's the thing about free writing.
You're sitting in an isolated. You're sitting and it's all coming out of your head. What I was saying is pull it out of the environment.
That's not true. The first free ride I ever did was out of a place.
Well,
it wasn't
the place
like,
that you were in, or was it a place in your head?
It was a place I was in. I was writing about a room I was in. I was looking around. I was describing things. That's the thing about a free ride. It's like whatever songwriting strategies you have, it's pretty much the same thing. It's just more like you write it down.
Yeah.
And
the only thing
like,
I reject sometimes is the theme based.
You're not editing. That's a free write.
Yes.
It's a free association.
Yeah, you could change subjects if you need to. If it comes to your head.
Well, extreme free write is true questions.
Yeah.
No, that's different than a free write.
That's an extreme free write.
A stream, it's not a free write. It's
that
a stream
a
of conscience.
How
it's
is it not a free
write? It's called a stream of conscience.
It's just
a different thing. Because a free write is a little more comprehensive.
The word's different.
Here's another approach.
Because like when you're free writing, you write like full sentences so that you have phrases. It's supposed to be so you can literally circle some phrases and maybe edit them a little bit. But like you basically have some phrases already there. It's not just like words, mind, thinking. Because
if you're
streaming
your conscience,
you're
still
free writing. Well, yeah, but it's not called
why not?
It's a stream of consciousness.
But it is free writing.
Oh my god, why are you getting so weird?
It's the same thing. It's just not.
It's a different type of
all these ideas are related.
It's just a type of
free writing. Right.
They're different things.
It's
but
a type of free
writing. This one's called a stream of consciousness.
All these ideas are in the same family. They're cousins.
Yeah, they are.
But a free write is also a stream of consciousness. It's a stream of consciousness.
No, it's not.
A stream of consciousness is a free
write. Okay, but it's about a name. Like a name of a thing, then the names of the things are different.
Hey, here's something even deeper.
I want to hear what Daddy has to say. That's deeper.
To take a vague feeling that you have and turn it into imagery. So, in other words, whatever feeling you're having at any particular moment, what images match that feeling?
Okay. Here we go.
I've done free writes like that. I've done all the free writes.